Hello and welcome to the Digital Bridge. I'm Paul Lawrence, Director of Information Literacy for Hampton City Schools. And today we're at Hampton's Science Magnet School, Cooper Elementary. And in Miss Kimball's tech lab, we have some kindergarten students who are about to get busy with some B-bots.
What is it, everybody?
Algorithm.
An algorithm. Remember, an algorithm is our set of directions when we put them together.
Today, the students were using their B-bots, and it was to kind of finish up their coding unit. We began with the internet, and we started with a code, our code program called Codable. And the students had to start with a little fuzz ball, and he had to go around and collect little stars. So the students were working on directions, forward, back, right, and left. And so once the students were able to start coding with the program efficiently, then we went ahead and took content from their classroom that they were working on and developed little mats for them to continue working on with that.
I was coding. Telling a robot what to do, or a computer, it's fun.
What we tell the students is coding means to tell a program or a device what to do. And in order to code, you develop algorithms or directions to make the device do what you're telling it to do.
Computers have fun things to do. We played with the B-bots.
Okay, what's a B-bot?
A B-bot is something telling directions what to do.
All of the students are usually very engaged, and it's not only the coding aspect, but not knowingly, they're doing the content as well. So they're reading the sight words. They're developing what's right, what's left, things that they already struggle with, but things that they need to master in kindergarten.
I told my B-bot to go right, I think forward, and then left, forward. It's like there's a little game on the computers, and we have a little person that's shaped like a ball, and he's super fuzzy, and the game's called Fuzzball, and you get to tell the fuzzball what to do.
So are you good at that game?
Yep.
As they get older, we usually use the first Google program, and they will use a program called Scratch. So they'll start developing their own programs and making a sprite or a character do different things. They might develop into their own game or to use it to problem solve, and they actually have to show the math problem through each step. So it really turns into developing simple skills throughout elementary school, and then eventually they can do robotics. I also started a Lego club this year, and they can partake in that in fourth and fifth grade.
What was great about today's lesson was not only are students developing the building blocks of computer coding skills, but they're also mastering some of the basic skills that they work on in their everyday class. Thank you for watching the Digital Bridge.